So today, Dr. Scholz, we're answering questions that came from our comment section, and a lot of prostate cancer patients have been leaving questions there, so it's really great we get to answer them here. Our first question is, this person wants to know that they've been on Zoladex for 6 years, and their PSA is undetectable, and they want to know, is there a risk in suspending it? Should they even take that chance or just keep on it?
Common situation we encounter. For those of you who don't know, Zoladex is like Lupron, and it causes a man's testosterone to become undetectable. And the patients that have good responses and durable responses like this individual, in my view, based on the science, certainly have the option of taking a holiday and allowing their testosterone to come back and see what happens. I think this has become even more relevant in the era. We've been talking a lot about PSMA PET scans. And in the past, we would allow the testosterone to return, PSA to rise up to 3, 4, or 5, and then reinstitute the hormone treatment. You don't want the situation to get out of control. But some men would enjoy holiday periods of a couple of years, enjoying their testosterone and more energy, some libido and whatnot. But now with these PSMA PET scans coming out, there's another upside to taking a holiday. As the PSA starts to rise, one can do a scan and possibly find where the cancer is, which may be amenable to some sort of spot radiation to try and eradicate the residual disease. So now there's possibly two reasons to think about taking a holiday with appropriate supervision. Another issue comes up is they stop the Zoladex, but the testosterone never comes back. Some elderly men that have been with low testosterone for many years, their testicles give up the ghost and they remain with constant low testosterone levels. And the question then arises, well, can they take some testosterone? And I think the answer is yes. We're really simply restoring testosterone when we stop Lupron, but if it doesn't generate autonomously, then the thought of taking a little testosterone to establish normal levels seems reasonable to me.
How long have you had a patient do intermittent hormone therapy? Like, how long have you seen those instances work where they're going off and going back on something like Lupron or Zoladex?
Well, some men, not very commonly, but some men stop treatment and their PSA remains low, their testosterone recovers and their PSA remains low for many, many years. So it's another reason to venture into this territory, because one individual may have a very long holiday period and be able to go back to a normal lifestyle.
You mentioned that, you know, for men who can no longer create testosterone, that, you know, testosterone replacement therapy is an option. Now, a lot of people have a lot of fear when it comes to testosterone because they think that testosterone feeds cancer. So can you speak to why it would be safe for men to take testosterone in that instance?
Yes, it turns out that because prostate cancer is often an indolent process and because it is very sensitive to testosterone deprivation, men with prostate cancer, unlike other cancers, but men with prostate cancer can take a holiday and with a high degree of confidence that when they start the hormone therapy again, the cancer will go back into remission very consistently. So if there'd been problems with the early studies where men ventured into this area and then they lost control of the disease, obviously this type of thinking would have been nixed a long time ago. But the predictability of prostate cancer is such that you can pretty much be assured that when you start the Zoladex or the Lupron back up again, that the PSA will go back once again predictably to undetectable levels.
So our next question is, what is the protocol for whether or not hormone therapy is started before, during, or after salvage radiation?
There is no protocol. There are only two clinical trials. One gave Lupron for 6 months. Another one gave Casodex for 12 months. And both of them showed more durable cure rates by adding hormone therapy to salvage radiation. We're talking about radiation therapy for men that have rising PSAs after surgery, and typically. That's all we've got. We've got the experience, of course, with hormone therapy in newly diagnosed and the information we have there. Timing in the newly diagnosed doesn't seem to make that big a difference. Most of the radiation therapists are going to want to start the hormone treatment before the radiation. That's been the policy for so long. It's never been tested clearly, but the typical mindset is start the hormone therapy and then start the radiation. The question comes, well, how many months of hormone therapy do you need before you start the radiation? And the limited trials that exist suggest that there's a lot of flexibility there, that it doesn't make that big a difference.
So a patient said that more than 6 months ago, after their final Lupron injection, they still have an undetectable testosterone, hot flashes and night sweats and a little sexual dysfunction, but the PSA is undetectable. So when can they expect to return to like pre-therapy conditions? When will the hot flashes stop? When will, you know, the fatigue and the night sweats stop?
So predicting testosterone recovery is an art that is dependent on how old the patient is, because men that are older, they're going to have slower return of their testosterone. And this is really what they're talking about, is the return of the testosterone. That's when things normalize. Also, men that have had longer treatment periods. So if someone has 3 or 4 months of treatment, their testosterone is going to come back more quickly. If they've had a year and a half, it's going to be slower. So older men that get treated for longer periods, some of those are never going to recover their testosterone production. And as we've covered it already, the possibility of implementing testosterone then is raised to try and restore normalcy. We typically, in patients that are stopping treatment, we tell them we want to give the body 6 to 12 months to recover on its own. And then if testosterone is not starting to recover, then we think about giving some testosterone to help hurry things along.
So getting specific into, you know, night sweats and hot flashes, is there anything that he can take in the meantime before maybe his testosterone recovers to help alleviate those issues?
Yes, there are medications such as gabapentin or Effexor that can temper the hot flashes. The most effective thing is estrogen. Estrogen patches are quite good at getting rid of hot flashes. You have to watch out for any type of breast enlargement with that. But medications to help hot flashes are good, then the acupuncture can help as well. So if it's become that big an issue, a lot of men, they're already on medicines, they don't want to take more medicines, but if it's waking people up at night, they can't get a good night's sleep, some sort of intervention starts to become very reasonable.
And in the case of sexual dysfunction, what is your advice for a man who is looking to recover his testosterone and that hasn't happened yet? Should he be, you know, on any sort of pills or doing anything in particular for this?
Yeah, well, a lot of men with low testosterone don't have that much interest in recovering their sexual function, but looking ahead to the day when their libidos come back, men should be, in our opinion, taking something like Cialis or Viagra to restore the nighttime erections, to keep the apparatus functioning normally for the day when the libido does return.
Hi everyone, it's Alex and Hunter. Hunter's our official PCRI mascot. If you'd like to learn more about men's health tips and prostate cancer, you can follow him on Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel. We come out with new prostate cancer videos every week. Say bye!